one Indigenous broadcaster championing the cause for the restoration of Biafra. Biafra Human Rights Radio. Of course, unstoppable and remains the beacon of truth.
I think I am able to successfully re-engage this program, and so this should be considered the part two of the same broadcast titled Know Your Category to enable you monitor your ways, amend your ways. Of course, you make mistakes, you are able to guide yourself if you are able to tell yourself the category where you belong to. It is simply titled Knowing Our Categories in order to enable us amend our ways. And so, like I was saying, our idea here is to take this project to a conclusive end. This ship we are sailing, we are the sailor, we are looking for a safe harbor, and then we can drop our anchor, and then every Biafran can come down from the ship and then begin to fashion how a nation will run in the nearest future. And as such, too much work to be done. We are your only last option now. IPUB has done its job at the future to be in the ship while you are drowned, because I know you certainly cannot swim. And now, that having been said, before I was disconnected from one of my platform, and for sake of record purpose, I have to make sure everything is on intact. But now I am back. I was talking about the third categories. I have made us to understand that the first categories of groups, individuals who are piloting this affair, you have the first category, which is that of China Sanwuru and the gangster called the DOS. I used to image there. And so in the nearest future, we will review them one after the other. China Sanwuru is behind every evil planning and atrocity against the people of Biafra. And then the gangster called the DOS are just zombies who will come out and give Nnamdi Kanu atrocity voice and make it look like real. They do not have the mind of their own. They don't have mind. And under that DOS, you have those who life on Nnamdi Kanu, Tony Chikedozie and the rest of it. Of course, you will see the details in the other clips before this one. There are three platforms there. The evil planners, the representatives, they don't have brain, but they just got to defend any evil to keep them relevant. And then you have the Abateke, those ones don't know. They just want you to feel everybody is involved. And I give you the examples of those names. And then on the second categories, we look at the bloggers and the recruits. They're making money on our expense. I beg you, subscribe, hit the button for me. Make sure they follow me. I give details there. They are dangerous. I must tell you the truth. And then under that category, the recruits, you are innocent. They took advantage of your youthfulness. They send you recharge card, 2,000. Chinasa will be on your inbox, bro. And then you come here and shamelessly, you think you are insulting me. You are insulting your father and your mother. You are insulting Nnamdi Kanu and his entire generation. Not me, except I have soiled my hand in this struggle. And then may your evil imagination come upon me. But if I have worked honorably, if I have sincerely defend the cause of you people, defend the cause of Biafra at large, defend the cause of even Nigerians. For Nigeria do not have the right, the moral ground to do to us what they are doing to us. All of us are just victims. Just that we have to fight from one end alone to be able to liberate ourselves, remove the log in our eye before we can try to save any other person. May I be left at the mercy of my enemy. And most of you, we know how you function. And that is why your character cannot influence or initiate any program in our system. So the recruit and the bloggers, they do not serve the overall interest of the people of Biafra. And of course, this time we're going to the third one. And that third one is to look at the third category, which is the opportunist and the Otimbo. If you are not telling me, you don't see opportunists on the platform. I can mention their name. Of course, if I choose to. If I don't mention their name tonight, that is because I want them to focus on their stupidity. But if I still want to mention their name, if they cannot do anything, I will expose you. And you will come down. But what will I gain if I have to kill all my people? What is the benefit if Nnamdi Kanu have to criminalize everybody who has divergent opinion or contrary view? You see, nothing. And so you have the opportunists and you think who's. The opportunists are the ones who somewhere along the line, the Tote Luhwa has promised Nnamdi Kanu Biafra. A lie from the pit of hell. There are certain decisions God do not take for man. Because he will be responsible for the outcome of such a decision. For instance, your pastor say, God will show me my wife. God will show me my husband. You are a demon. God is no longer in the business of giving husband and wife. Because the only people he supposedly gave husband and wife, when problem came, he was blamed for it. Because Adam started by saying, God, the woman will you give me, now he deceive me. And so God cannot take them to any competent court jurisdiction and win the case because he was the initiator. And that is why men of God will tell you, he who found the wife, I'm going to find my wife. My wife cannot find me. And if she finds me and I look at her barometer and diameter and see is walking in the same direction with that of mine, and then I have found mine. She didn't find me. You get the point now. And so that having been said, let's not digress further. We go back to this opportunist. Some of them thought Biafra is here. They came in on our expense. And okay, this Onyibe said, who is this Onyibe? Or Oguaja, he's a block mother. You be idiot. You don't have sense. And then they tell Nnamdi Kanu, you people don't know what we heard. Some of them were telling Nnamdi Kanu. Nnamdi Kanu were gossiping with some people that they say George Onyibe is the key to this struggle, that George Onyibe is going to be the next leader. Some people believe that is why Nnamdi Kanu want me dead. But what do I have to lead such group of intelligent and complicated people? Do I have it? We hear this gospel reach inside the US. Prophet, then prophesy for Nnamdi Kanu, say George Onyibe na the leader of this struggle. Which person for DOS we know? And most of you lousy clowns who don't know anything. You join them immediately. We have to destroy this guy quickly. Are you trying to assume supremacy, leadership for all? You want to build a caliphate on top of our head, or you are here to free our people and the fate of this nation, Biafra? We leave it for progressive-minded individual to fashion a way forward for the next generation. And I never know what we know. We know all those things because we keep quiet. And so the opportunities came. They have to destroy Umaru Bide. What is our coordinator in Brazil then? That man and Obidi were put on the same line. But I think both of you look like, I understand you are the same category. Because Mazio Obidi, Dr. Okado, and that coordinator in Brazil, I don't know his name. He talk to you real. He call Chikiduzi. If you talk to yourself, he will call you, give you your history, and tell you why we did here. May you respect yourself. Because they cannot mugu these people. These people are not opportunists. And then opportunists, now they can say, oh, you are a monkey. Say, yes, so I'm a monkey. Who the hell are you to call me a monkey when I know I'm not one? Just look at your life. If you are a zombie, they say, Amanda, you sit at home, and now you begin sit at home. And then on Tuesday, they say, no more sit at home. You begin to say, no more sit at home. Look at you. Your brain is not working well. Those categories of people, it is dangerous to keep the fate of a nation in their hand. The vice president of Biafra, Nnamdi Kanu, your brother, Kanu Takano, gave you as a zombie simple instruction. Do not initiate sit at home. Our children are writing a very important exam. And then the moguls under the DOS, no, we cannot agree. Oh, and then the canon brother cannot be our president. I thought he's your savior. Die for him now. You don't want his brother to be your vice president. And you are professing you will die for him. You think you are deceiving us. And after they have played their game, they now come back and say, the same DOS that counter canon. Now say, now no more sit at home. Onyendu has spoken. And of course, all of you are there. But your category, we know you. You be mumu, you be mugu, better one. Asare Dokobogo says, 70 years old man. 70 years old man. You know, get him. Those are those categories. And many of you, intellectuals, according to Nnamdi Kanu, you fall under that category. But you don't see anything wrong with what you are doing because you have been in that category. My brother, shift back a little bit. Review your activities so far. You'd see, some of you, how much you have messed up yourself. I say they are the opportunities and Otimbu. The Otimbus have nothing to offer. When Mazim Efo had issue, the same issue that led us to this point, there were some musicians that sing some beautiful music. Eh, Uche me for God, you. Uche me for Nyoma. Eh, we Uche me for. Okwa yin sanyi so wena ne kano. Uche me for. Eh, God, you. Oga de regi nama. Eh, we nande kano. Eh, oka anu ne juon we. Oh, nande kano. Okwa yin sinige bulanyo. Oga masenun we. And then they now put the judge on Ibi. The same people, but we know how you function. You are Nigerian-oriented criminal. The same people now, with that same mouth now, hey, we, Odekanu Chema, oh, if you go no Che, betray, go Nandekanu, do you have proof? Do you have evidence? But of course, you are Otimbu. Begin to Otimbu. You see, we have developed defense mechanism for you. You see, that which you thought is your strength, you use it against anybody. He has lost his power even before your very eyes. Can't call us saboteur now. You can't call us bad name now. Tell them what we do now. Oh God, understand, I'm not talking to all Biafrans in this manner. There's people I'm talking to, they know. And if by adventure you have ignorantly moved to the wrong category, you have to, retrace yourself and save yourself and the next generation. Because it will not go down the way you think. Otimbu, Ewe, is a God, go bless him. Yes, our Biafra. You are Biafra. But of course, as many competent nations who want to join that league at that time can be part of it. Nation is formed through mutual agreement. Of course, values has to be reviewed. And then instrument of law, justice, and all that will be initiated to serve as a check and balance, shock observer, to manage conflicting ideas, cultures, and traditions that may bring problems in the nearest future. And so, if you say you are, of course, it is possible. But for you now to undermine the position of the stakeholders just because you want it to be recognized, that is not acceptable. You are Otimbu. I see people come on Radio Biafra, talk about me, and they don't even know how I look. I work among our people here in Nigeria for almost 4 years. They don't know me. It is my voice they know. There is no meeting I have gone to that anybody will know I'm George Onyebe, except the organizers. Why? Because I'm a spirit? No. I do not sit on high table. I don't like it. But they force me at the end, you must sit there. And then number two, I'm not flashy anyway. I'm just a local village boy. But I have my sense intact. And I work hard to live by the principle and dignity and honor my father taught me. These are my guiding words. And so when they introduce me in most cases, yes, let's welcome our African rep, George Onyebe. And then I come out from one corner or wherever I'm sitting. And then when they look me, some will think, even Abaye, they will think the moderator is making fun of them. And then when I sing, and then when I finish, everybody will say, you know, say if no be your voice, I no go believe you. So now you be this. Nobody takes a kingdom by words. You take it by action. So if you like blackmail your papa, blackmail anybody. If you no be, you no be. So every genuine Biafran across the globe, check yourself. You should say you know Biafra. All of now, we don't lie down for embassy. Come lie down, do everything, jump up and now. Kenya embassy, you know the trend again. Can't you see you wasted your time? You will think everything planned. Protocol, procedures that is initiated must be geared towards doing something. De facto, customary government may not be very fast as expected by every people. And believe me, we are not on a speed competition. And so it requires meticulous and systematic thinking. And we will take all the time that we need to be able to do the right thing. And of course, we understand time is of the essence. And so, opportunist. They are waiting. Simeon Ekpa and his gang are waiting. They want to overthrow the DOS. And Chinasan has perceived it. And he has set up his gadget. But come to think about it. What did Simeon do? Are they tired for now? When I no get sense. I can condemn Chinasan for all I care, condemn the DOS. But they have so much they have risk for the struggle. And sometimes they just feel it cannot be undermined by anybody. But in trying to do that, they begin to destroy the people that they are supposed to protest. And then they begin to consider everybody as a perceived enemy. And some of you are behind there. Let Simeon do it. Simeon can do it. He can lead us. The inside is Biafra. You don't know there are people who are still watching in on the canoe to get his head back. You don't know when the order is given now. The people who will take this order, it will shock you. These are men. And then we look at the fourth one, the passionate and the genuine activists. You are the people why we are turning it down. You have made so many mistakes. The passionate, I call that category the passionate and the genuine activist. You are the reason why we take this pain, insult, and get here. You don't know how I feel. Somebody will call me up and say, Mas Onyebe, Thank you for what you have been doing. And the reason I'm calling you is I'm just confused. I don't know. We had your broadcast, and that is why we gave everything to this struggle. What is going on now? And so if these people go to hell because of IPUB, I am responsible. And because of such people, we are taking time to help them recover. They are the passionate one. They make all manner of mistakes because they believe in one thing and they believe it holistically. Do not feel bad about yourself. You did the right thing. But this is the time for you to review what you have done and compare the voice that invited you and reevaluate what that voice is saying. You will be guided spiritually. You will know the truth and it will set you free. You're passionate. It's just like when Jesus said, the zeal of my fathers has consumed me. We understand all of you. Believe me, God will wipe your tears. God will help you to stand these challenges. But don't betray Biafra. If you see I'm doing the wrong thing, fight against me. Put an end to me. And so be any other person you perceive to be genuine enemy of this cause. We understand. You are the reason why we are looking for process to separate the wheat from the chaff. I said, most of you have made terrible mistakes. We understand. There is a woman I respect so much, very passionate woman. And when this issue began to come, the woman called me that she saw a vision that God told her to warn me not to challenge Nandekano. That Nandekano is a divine being, and if I challenge Nandekano, I was going to be destroyed. And the woman told me that why he believed the prophecy is that Nandekano made a statement in one of his broadcasts that George Onyebe had been removed, and that if he misbehaved, they will tell me the king they will use to flog me. Obuagwo call him here. I just listened to that woman. I say, this woman don't understand me. Now that place then say no go. Now we they go. Now so it be for our life. We are the ungifted. We do not have power to kill anybody. And nobody can kill us. Go and find out who the ungifted are. We can't do juju for anybody. Nobody can do juju for us. Most of you today are slaves because you have not been able to find out who you are spiritually. 101 million and none cannot wake me up from my sleep. You know, go fit, not to talk of kill me. Rubbish. And what are those people? See, I have a higher moral grounding. So your passion has misled you. Repent. Check your categories. So help yourself out. Those categories. You have aside this passionate one, genuine one. That is why when some people insult us, we go just look you pass. Your eye go open. And that is the best thing for you. And then, of course, finally, we look at the watchmen, the spectators category. The watchman and the spectators. In that category, they are watching. They are watching. They know the truth. They are waiting for the right time to strike. They are all over the world. We call them the watchmen. And they simply tell you we go nowhere. Any platform we did, everywhere we did. So those of us, they try to say, we did this, we did this. We know, say, hungry go soon finish the remaining unknown gunmen and ESM. They're just looking for how to get their life back. And I've called most of you whose life have been damaged by IPOB to contact Biafra Nation Alliance family into the ongoing program and project of rehabilitation, skill acquisition, youth empowerment, among other programs that are going on, to empower Biafran youth and redirect them to be ready for what is to come. We do not have enemy. Certainly we do not have friends, but we are able to deal with those people who believe in the same ideology with us. So because you are an IPUB or any other pro-Biafran group does not mean we see you as enemy. You still are a brother. Misguided one. And the hearing men when you are gone warrior. And Aguayora, if you are mad, will kill you. Understand clearly there is a difference between you are crazy and you are mad. We say we diagnose you. It's okay anyway. And so this having been said, we now look at the conclusion of this discussion tonight is that you must find out where you belong. And you do not use, you have to use, that is, you have to function with a guided morality. Because much depends on it. Find out the category you belong to. And my appreciation later when I was supposedly expelled for no reason. Somebody just come and open all the eyes. You expel. You decrease. Who you expel for Biafra? But of course, you have been leaving it out. Benjamin Madubuku under Nnamdi Kanu and China's directive said I should not enter Anambra again. Na Anambra bo ibe nawa. And I told them, man, if you pass River Niger now, eba ho bo ibe nawa. So where this Biafra come? Make una no come there. Do you understand? If they could do this thing to me, I will only live in fear how Biafra will be. If I can be African rep, a member of the DOS of IPOB for such a long time, and they banned me not to be meeting in Biafra land without taking permission from Ikechukwu Gwoha, who is just a Biafran land national coordinator. Don't I have right to begin to think how my life is going to be inside that Nnamdi Kanu Biafra? And memos were written to this effect. Is it because I'm not publishing it? It's unheard of. It's uncalled for. This is unacceptable. People were afraid of me. And you still accept these things. But my wife understands that advantage of strength I have. I take rubbish well. But so why wouldn't they ban me from entering Biafra when it comes? But are you hearing about Benjamin Madubuku? Otherwise, they die, they hide for police, they run for DSA. But now the Kanu brother, they go America with Allen Onyema, chop with Yoruba, chop with Fulani. They don't go a whole DSS office. I thought DSS office is a demon zone. And now, how could Barristo Star Hotel? I was thinking the DSS people don't have sense. And of course, at this moment, I will stop this broadcast here. I encourage you to find out the category you belong to, because it has a lot to do with your position, your activities in this restoration project. Our lines are open at this moment. And of course, our WhatsApp line remains 070-815-45642. For the last time, the WhatsApp line is 070-815-45642. I'll encourage you to call in and make your positive contribution, as the case may be. And of course, our direct line is 081-221-52971. I repeat again, 081-221-52971 is our direct number. If you are not able to access any of this number, and you have access to my private media platform, you are free to call in if you have access to them. And of course, let our people begin. Consider the categories that they belong to, because all that glitters are not gold, and there are more beneath than the eyes can see. Let us have a very healthy, positive, interactive session this evening. And so, like I said, the lines are now open, and you are free to call in. And of course, if after some time we don't have any call coming in, we will move on to end the program. But whatever you do, understand, according to Fela, I say, me and you no be the same category. And any category where you belong to, it has so much role to play. I am joined by Dr. Okado. At this moment, can you hear me, sir?
Hello, good evening from here. Jock Bonny, good evening.
Good evening, sir. I am happy to have you on board this evening. You're welcome, sir. Go ahead, the world is listening.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much. The pleasure is mine. Speaking is Emeka Okeabe. Emeka Okeabe is from Ekiti in Okigwe province of Biafra land. Permit me to express my gratitude and appreciation to all our listeners all over the world. And I renew my gratitude for having me in this program. Please, call my attention or cut me off if you feel that I'm taking much of the time, because I like to say a few things.
You have all the time, sir.
So, yes. Thank you. First of all, I should start by expressing my great appreciation to you. I should always renew it. My appreciation to you. And I will tonight start to express that with a citation. The citation is from the director of Biafra Intelligence of the First Republic, Bernard Odogwu. In his memo that has been declassified, he explicitly noted that most loyal Biafrans were more from the minority areas, that's the Riverines and Old Oweri province. Inverted comma closes. I repeat, this is a declassified report of the director of Biafra Intelligence, Bernard Odogwu, of the First Republic. Most loyal Biafrans were more from the minority areas or the Riverines and the Old Oweri province. He was writing on the integrity of Biafrans. So why I'm making this citation is that for you to know that your root is all. So many that even understand the role you're playing, it's not, you're not acting. This is part of your culture, as you have been saying, and it's part of your root. So the citation I met tonight was made by Director of Biafra Intelligence, Bernard Odogwu. And as you can see, has been exemplified in Philip Echam for his loyalty and sincerity. And as we all know, to his death, he never denied having led Biafra and was ready also to do it if it comes again. So kudos and more grace. You have a strong taproot and strong root. We are learning much from that. So, maybe unnecessary distractions. We are all away after the defeat of the First Republic, there were a lot of contradictions and denial on the part of most of the key players. We know that from all the areas, both from the Riverine and from the upper land of Biafra. But that's not the issue. What is evident and that has been transmitted to us is that the integrity of Biafrans were more identified with the minority areas of Biafra, that's those from the Riverines. That will take me to my second point this evening. My second point is on the question of audience questions and answers. please, my administrator of BNA and Secretary General of Government of Biafra, I pledge your audience stop taking these questions and answers, because it is not necessary. Stop taking that causing demand for that. Please refute it, because what is very indispensable for us with the what you've been doing is that you've been educating, you have been reevaluating, you have been giving appraisal to all effort we have made all these years. And recently, all is targeted to see how to rehabilitate most of the subculture he has created. So, you are taught. Because most times they become a distraction to the program. So I beg your indulgence, if you can please stop taking this audience questions and answers. Rather, my own opinion is that it's you that has the privilege to ask certain questions, something like name, place of call, and the pro-Biafran group of that. That's not to stop anyone from views liberally or possibility of freedom. But the point is that, please, don't permit audience to be now with this their tendency of questions. It's causing distraction to the program. I will appreciate if you can put this into consideration. And then the point I would like to...
Before you continue, I will make sure...
Stress upon is the issue.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me? Can you hear me, Doctor?
Yes, I'm listening.
Yes, I heard your request.
Yes, I'm listening.
I heard your request regarding answering question. And honestly, I know Mazi Obidi has been looking for a way to talk me out of the same issues. He has talked to me like a father. He has challenged me, he has appealed to me, and many other people. I can tell you, I was shocked some days ago. Dr. Clifford Iruanya wrote to me and said, don't let them distract you. And if you will still come up on air and say that, I give you my word tonight, sir. I will not attend to any question that has nothing to do with my topic on that very day. And I must apologize to...
Because remember, you are our leader. You are our leader. We have to defend your image too. Yes. You are a leader. You are the flag bearer of our struggle, of our project this time. Only that we are generating. You are giving us this opportunity of hearing from you every day. Remember, it's an act of generosity. Yes. So we are satisfied only with your thoughts and not. It's unnecessary question, and no, we don't. It's not necessary.
Okay. And as a result,
you should hold the privilege to ask.
Yes, I want to see those that I may have offended by continually entertaining most of those questions in time past who are not happy. I apologize to all of you, but at the same time, I give you my word there will be no room for such discussion, question and answering, as it has been distraction in time past. From this night, I make that promise. Thank you very much for still standing.
You humble us. You humble us. Thank you very much.
Right, sir.
Thank you for that. My number 3 points is on the issue of restoration. Which Agunwan, Onyeka, and others powerfully and correctly the other time with the question of if it is a struggle. I am of the opinion, as I concluded in my submission as of that day, we should harmonize the two. It's a struggle and project. The Biafra restoration the word of Professor Chido Swago. He said that it is a deep, deep issue which involves struggle of civilization. So it is a struggle, and at the same time, it's a project, because it's a struggle that involves a project, meaning that it's a struggle that involves practical for its realization, and there comes in the project. So what I'm trying to say for our brainstormers that we are trying to develop, that is giving very big quality to our broadcast, they should continue on is that we can harmonize the two. It can be a struggle and project for the reasons I have given. The number 4 point that I would like to express this evening concerns that of participation and representation, which I know Mefo, the director of the Afro Human Rights and Freedom Radio, has a very strong position. And Chimezie's analysis is very, very interesting. But there is a stumbling block, because all along, as Obienu had already made mention, the Biafran struggle or project has never shared away, we've never the system is quite intolerant. What I mean, the Nigerian system, which is corrupt and complications, makes it to be impossible. But still, as I said, you can't, because of debt, and avoid maybe going to battle. The issues. That's fundamental right of participation and representation, which is one of the core issues in any democratic setup. So, but the only thing is that we have to be very careful when we talk about participation and representation, because it was a discussion that dominated our reflections this week. We must have to be very careful. We don't have to jump into it. And we don't have to think that we have not tested it. We have, in many ways, even which the father of the nation, Chief Raf Wazurika, has testified sometime in one of his speeches. But the issue now is that my own opinion is that we can still participate and be represented. try to use a word in defining, we can interface. And this interface is a complex process. And we have a foundation for that. As far back as 50 years ago, we have a very ideological foundation which the First Republic laid down, which the termed Memorandum on Future Association with Nigeria. That can be a foundation that can enrich us on this kind of participation and representation we can have with the system, which is very, very complex and corrupt, as I said. Well, I'm not trying to ideological over the question, because it's a practical question. It's a practical question and a question that must have to be addressed. I will express my opinion, which I've had you sometimes express too. For instance, you've expressed the opinion of calling on our citizens, Biafrans, to go and have their PVC for the Anambra election. I second you. I'm in support of that. Our citizens should go and have their PVC for Anambra election. As you can see, it's within that area of this participation and representation. And another practical example I might give in regards is that if you ask me, should we support 2023 presidency or Nigerian election, I will tell you no. In that case, I will buy the position of Nenas that there should be no election in 2023. I am expressing my own personal opinion in this for some, but what I am trying to say is that this is the complexity of the issue in question. And then that part of legislative representation and participation, it is complex. But in that aspect, I won't like to say certain things about it on the air, because I feel that a policy strategy that don't need to be exposed on the air. But it is very, very complicated. But who is seeing it as me? But I am talking about that from little experience also, having been a legislator. It's very, very complex. But saying that it's complex doesn't mean that it's no-go area, because as I said, right from the beginning of the new dispensation of Biafra, the position of every one of the group, of the pro-Biafran group, is that there must be a way for us. So, but however, the issue we are saying requires brainstorming and conversation and discussion. But I think the most important thing that is needed, which I know that very soon it will be coming up, is that the government of Biafra need to have a policy statement in all over. Government, but to enrich this guideline policy statement, I think the debate and discussion and conversation that has been open is very healthy, and from my own opinion should continue. That's what I have to say over that. Then the number 5 point I would like to also pinpoint in this my participation of de facto government. I've said it before, we must have to make clear distinction of de facto government from pro-Biafran organization. De facto government is an administrative political body, a neutral administrative political body that has to build its competence. not only building it, but must also step in with it. So for that reason, it doesn't call for any belonging or what. Everyone should identify with it, whereas the pro-Biafran organizations, they are nothing less than interpreters. They are interpreters of what Biafra is or is not. And then it's left to any one of us to use our conscience and reasons to filter the one that is true or not. So the two is different. So that's why all effort must be laid down, made to consolidate the fact of government of Biafra, because as an administrative political body, it's going to be a catalyst for the restoration. Without it, we may not even, talk anything. Like, you can see the years that has been spent without doing anything, because there has not been the right thing that is supposed to be done. Then the last point that I have to say, that's the conclusive point before I hand over the listing to you, is the issue of timing. We have said it before, we have been very, very unreasonable with this dispensation of this present generation. It is disgraceful and very, very unreasonable. It's time, we have to realize that and make amend of it. An instance for most of us to understand is that, think of that the introduction of Biafran currency, took the First Republic. Only 3 months. 3 months. It took them only 3 months to realize, in the sense that in the new year of 1968, the one announced the introduction of currency by 1st of March 1968. And that was a strategy to clamp down on the new formed Republic of Biafra. It took Republic of Biafra only 3 weeks. 3 weeks. Introduce a new currency for the new republic. It took them only 3 weeks after the announcement that was made by the one during the New Year of 1968. By 27th of January 1968, the head of state of Biafra introduced the first new currency of the new republic. This will show you how efficient and capable our great fathers and grandfathers were on what we are kidding over today with much noise and deceit. And another example I might give will be that of, think of, many of us do think that even that Britain didn't recognize Biafra, but I will tell you an incident, incident that Effiong, Philip Effiong, through his, with all the, according, I could say, blessed memory of Philip Effiong, that's what I intend to say, through the courtesy of the fourth son, that's Philip Effiong II, who has energetically engaged in transmitting and informing the world or the Biafran citizens on the legacies of his father. In one of his recent works, which is his autobiography entitled the cage bird sang no more. My Biafra Odyssey of 1960 to 1970 by Major General Philip Effiong, presented by his son, that's Philip Effiong, which, however, he did also here in London in August 17, 2019, of which I participated also. I think during a genocide exhibition here in London, he presented this book, I'm saying. But I'm just trying to pinpoint an image that is also important in regards to timing. Many of us think that Britain didn't recognize Biafra. Philip Effiong clearly stated and narrated the Odyssey he had on the 26th of August, 1968. He said that Mr. Ugweche, who was the Minister of Foreign Affairs of Republic of Biafra, informed him that he had received a message from Dr. Nnamdi Azikiwe, who was in London, and wanted him to join him there. He was going to give a press conference on 28 August and wanted to take advantage of the fact that that Philip Effiong was in Europe, because this is his autobiography. Without giving a second thought to what could happen to me in London, I accepted the invitation and accordingly left the following day, 27th August, 1968. Arriving in London, Philip Effiong wrote, the immigration officer scrutinized my passport, that's Biafran passport, and that of his ADC. He immediately became curious. He took them into the inner office and was away for about 3 minutes. Then he came out with, Philip Effiong said, I believe. He came out with, Philip Effiong believe, someone that was a senior immigration officer. The letter wanted to know why it was that, although the passport has been issued on the same day, the numbers were inconsistent. The numbers of the passport, the serial numbers of the passport. Listen, it's important. I was surprised but said that the explanation was very simple. He said, I requested a serial number. As you can see, the number is 5, repeated 5 times. What am I trying to say? Meaning that the passport, Biafran passport number of Philip Effiong was 55555. That's 5 repeated into 5 times. And he told the British immigration officer, so what could be easier if that's the number? He said he concluded with a smile, and he smiled back. The immigration officer nodded his head and stamped our passport. So you can see, they traveled to Britain with Biafran passport as of this time. This is an autobiography of Philip Effiong. He went further, concluding by saying, we were met by one of the Biafran representatives and drove into the Biafran Mission Building in London. This was gotten from page 187 of his autobiography. So what am I trying to say? You can see within such a short time, they introduced Biafran currency, Biafran passport that was used to travel over the world. Within a short time, we are talking of 1968, not even up to a year, almost a year after the declaration of the Republic. And when we look at the immensity of the achievement, why are we making noise and fooling ourselves all about? So I will leave it here. What I am trying to say is that anyone that feels had to be done, because the restoration of Biafra is a reality. I thank you very much for giving me all this time. And I wish you all the best. And God bless. Thank you very much. And thank you for to all the listeners. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Dr. Okado. And of course, considering the how long you have been on this journey with that great expectation that by now Biafra is supposed to be a thing of the past. Of course, it's okay. The generation of 1967 and 1970 are the one who had laid the very foundation. We are only sharing from the glory of what they've labored for, and many of them are still alive and watching us. But then people should understand this is something all of us have a very important role to play. Caller on the line, your name and where are you calling from? Caller on the line, can you hear me? I haven't connected, but can you hear me? Call a line. I may advise you to maybe you cut the call and call back. Try and see if you can come back, because I was not hearing you. And so, like I was saying, this generation of Biafra has a lot to offer. They have a lot to do. But the challenge now is that most of us are practically destroying every legal instrument which would have aided in the quick restoration of Biafra. And then, if we do not take time to reveal some of these things to our people, they may even blame you for it. I understand from the beginning of this year, and of course, towards my last broadcast, September, almost a year today, and then in IPOB platform, I keep telling people, Nnamdi Kanu has practically destroyed everything that will give us Biafra. If not for the timely intervention of Radio Biafra Human Rights, by now they will criminalize us.
Hello, good evening, sir.
Good evening from here, my brother. Your name and where are you calling from?
My name is James, calling for Biafra Land.
Go ahead, please.
I thank God to Dr. Kabu for his sermon. In fact, he's a good Biafran. I thank you, Mr. George Oyibe, for your resilience. In fact, I thank God on behalf of other Biafrans for what you have done to our people. Till the day we shall be free and free once and for all. My good brother, the issue of Biafran restoration belongs to us and depends on us. In fact, you have shown us the way. You have shown us the way. I've been listening to you since 3 or 4 months now. Every night, I've been listening to you. From what you have just said, it shows that we are a true Biafra. Whoever said that you should not come to Anambra State is a liar, because you're a true Biafra. I have never in my mind, though I'm not an IPOB member, but I'm a Biafra, I have never believed that you are a saboteur. And you can never be a saboteur. Because if you want to be a saboteur, you can be it when Nnamdi Kanu was in Kuje prison. Which is for the same thing. You people fight very hard to see that your man was released. How can you come now and become a saboteur? I have already believed. But my advice is, as I used to say, by forcing somebody like what was the doctor says, I like his sermon. But the only thing I have to say on this is take it easy. Because by answering hard voice, I know the other day you have said that it's your voice. Maybe, but cool it down so that other people understand what you are saying and the points that you are making. So take it lightly with the caller. Some of them are calling you. are wanting to, don't believe they are questioning you. They wanted to know what is in you and what truth you have, that is coming out of your side. Because this is where two elephants are fighting. And it's the girls that are going to suffer it. So that is my only advice. I can never call you a saboteur. You are not a saboteur. Just you are not a saboteur. You are a true Biafra. And whoever calling you a saboteur don't know what he is saying. That is, I'm not a person in this issue. I've been listening to the two sides. I have seen what is the truth and what is false. So thank you, my good brother. Thank you for your resilience. Continue to the day we shall be free and be free once and for all. God bless you.
Thank you very much, my brother. Thank you. And I appreciate your contribution. And of course, the people of Biafra, the line is open. Dr. Kadomid, I will say, capping up the contribution of Dr. Kado to this program this evening is that we are taking too much time. And honestly, that is true. Inasmuch as we'll also remind us that we are fighting more complicated enemy who has taken time, over 60 years, to set up plans to undermine our sovereignty. But then we cannot give excuses. I think we don't have any excuse to give. But like our topic this evening, it is connected by knowing your category. Which category do you belong to? If you're able to answer that question, ask yourself that question, answer yourself that question genuinely, you will be able to understand when you are deliberately making mistakes. And of course, it could lead to something good in future. But you should know your category. Very important. Kanun ejekwa kwefa. And of course, my brother who just made his own contribution, I will say amen to your prayers. We will continue like that. I fight very well, but I do not fight to win. I fight so that all of us will win in the end. And not until we all arm ourselves with such mindset. We will be very eager to destroy our people. Forget about the momental peace and stability we are enjoying. A lot of damage has been done to the very fabric foundation of our cultures, our values. You people are not seeing it. But of course, we are still working on the ground to make sure such mindset is alienated from the character of our people, because we will not survive it. Today we are confident talking about Biafra, and that is because the generation of 1967 and 1970 did it on their honor, Come and diruge di chianye kenu abawasia, and that is from one of those Petros songs, I think, by Achuzet and his men. On their honor, anything we want to talk about them, they all end up giving us a sense of belonging, pride. And then maybe you begin to understand when Dim Chukwuemeka Odumegwu Ojukwu said that they declare this Biafran phenomenon without apology. And we must make sure that while we embark on this journey, while we sojourn on this quest, We cannot criminalize Biafra. We cannot be an instrument to criminalize Biafra. Not even our friends, enemy, could be given such privilege to that. And then, if we fail, which I know we will not, and then when we leave this, the scene of time, the next generation can be talking about us. As we were talking about the generations of 1967 and thereabout. And so the people of Biafra here in Biafra land, but rest assured, we are not giving an inch to anybody. It is Biafra or Biafra. We've all been wounded. We all have our monsters. We must continue to fight it together until we are able to come to a conclusive end where together we can take the last push and then free generation. It is not about anybody, yet it is about everybody. We continually calling you. This is with the platform where you can have your say in our say. And in as much as we are inching closer to the end of this program, I want to remind our people, Biafran in Anambra State, our relay station FM is up and running. From Ogbaru down to Onitsha, Mpo Aziz, you can receive Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station on FM. Tere Aziz. And of course, check those distance, 300 degree radius. You'll be able to get Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station on FM. And of course, those of you in Delta State, Obawosa, down to Nzene, and its environment, you will receive Biafra Human Rights and Freedom Radio Station on FM. And then in River State, from some side of area of Igirita to Eneka, around Rukwoko, Aziz, down to Rumo Domanya, and of course Rumo Koro, Wimpy, Rumo Moi, Rumo Roshi, Rumo Kuta, and its environment. And of course, you will get it if you are living in those areas. We are on Simple Radio, we are on satellite, and of course, we are on app. Another platform will be coming up. And we encourage you. Information is the key and it is power. Information is the key and knowledge is the power. We have this relay station in every community. Let our people be coming out to tell us what is really going on. A lot of atrocities is going on and our people do not have ways to communicate to us what is going on. And I tell you, if they have this relay station, they will be able to communicate with us. Contact the head of administrators at every level in Biafran, Biafran Nation Alliance. Talk to our broadcasters. You have Mazi Ukuyomoka there in Canada. You have Audio Guinea in South Africa. You have Mbadike. You have Mazi Paul Ukumukum. You have Adadi Mazi Ubidi. People who always coming to you need to meet them. Believe me, it's going to take all of us to save all of us. Of course, I will not go further because I have my dad in the Lord standing by already. Can you hear me, please, Mazi Ubidi?
Yes, I can hear good you, evening, my brother. Thank here. You, my reverend.
And finally, all our battle all these years, you won me today. You're welcome, sir.
Well, blessed be to the name of God. I understand that you're going to express your grievances at the same time, but what we're doing here is to, call it out and continue to move on. Thank God that God is in this business. And more expose is ongoing, okay? So, but we know we face a greater challenge because of a lot of people does not understand what we are trying to do here. And it's important that we continue to emphasize on it, and at the same time, call out evil that has begotten our people today. And by the way, my name is Obidio Bien. Obidio Bien is from Oba. Oba is in Onitsha province. Let me thank you for having me today. I just went off and start talking, but I must appreciate you for what you do for Bia friends. Dr. Kaido, thank you very much. More of this is required because when I'm calling here, I'm also calling out everybody to come and help our people. We are in a precarious situation, and time is running. Time is against us already. It's against us already. I just saw another video the other day where these young guys were. They had all kinds of weapons chained around them, smoking whatever they are smoking, and they are happy. And people are not looking at all these things. I mean, I know that most of their strategies are to scare us. So, because that's what they do, scare tactics. Everyone that knows how they should fight knows that they take time to fight. You remember what their forefathers said. They're going to conquer this. This is their conquered territory. But guess what? Anytime they make a move and people shout, they withdraw and they keep quiet. They'll come again. They keep trying and trying until they completely fulfill their goal. And it's so sad that our people are not getting this message. So sad. Looking at people in Anambra State now talking about all the groundbreaking work they have done in Anambra State. And I see this man, I don't even know his name, Ezadrianono Nalaiba Anasina Ife Buhari, in Anambra State. Also, in all the roads that they, you know, that they thank him. Hey! When I see Mokane Kwifa or Ebeko Sipota, where did they come from? Where did they come from? I'm not there, but people that travel home talks about this. People that are home since this of Enugu Road, Enugu Ancha Road, Enugu Port Harcourt Road, Aba Port Harcourt Road, and so many other roads in Biafra land that I cannot name. I remember there's another road that passes from Asaba area to River State, that they said that Fulani has occupied everywhere. People cannot even travel. I've seen things like that. But anyway, focusing on this man that I see yesterday, I saw him yesterday after they congregated with Hopus of them talking about APC and the ruling party. I couldn't stop crying. And we don't know if what we're seeing is different from what these people are seeing. We don't know. But the point is that we are taking a long time with all this ongoing drama from all corners. People that are bent on deceiving people, they are lying to themselves, and they are bullying you and telling you that you are lying. As a matter of fact, they are a stumbling block. This is real stumbling block, my reverend. Real stumbling block, because the reason they are stumbling block, that people who are not even involved, people who are not part of this process, are now the ones that are jumping all over the place. And they are not listening. They are not listening. I'll give you one example. There was one interview that Dr. Kado sent me yesterday that they granted to Professor Ejiofor here in the United States. And they went all the way to ask him a series of questions. I love the interview. But when it came to the issue of Biafra and the support for Nnamdi Kanu, he got it wrong. He got it wrong. In as much as all that he has given on this interview were correct, when he came to Nnamdi Kanu, he got it wrong. Because Professor Ejiofor, with all his educational qualification, it was amazing to hear that he has been to so many places to acquire all this knowledge. But today, he himself, who supposed to be in the forefront of this struggle is supporting a lunatic. Because of what? He thought that apparently Biafra is saying. And the sad part of it is that he's not looking at all the variables. But all he's talking is about supporting a criminal of our time. And we will continue to speak on this issue until people understand it. That we all want Biafra. We came out for Biafra. Push the agenda of Biafra with Nnamdi Kanu. He got to a point. It seemed like he became greedy over money, became greedy, became a god, became everything. And began to blackmail the people he was doing something with. And Ejiofor, I remember seeing him for the first time in 2019 in Atlanta. He don't even know me. But because when he came into that hall in Atlanta, just because of respect, I'm always That's why I always talk about this issue of humility. I gave up my seat for him and his wife when they came inside the hall. He didn't know me. In the real sense of it, Nnamdi Kanu wouldn't have left that hall with him without introducing me. Because I introduced him in the United States. We brought him here. We paid his ticket. We kept him in a hotel. Where he's still. Now, no introduction. He jumped over everybody because of his personal gains and personal interest. That said, this agent came in between this issue. I would think that a father, an elder, who came between a problem, will try to find out what is going on and try to resolve the problem before he takes sides. Or before he takes sides, yes. But what did he do? They came in immediately and took sides. Jenyon Kuolu, the lunatic, ludicrous news, uncle. On our auto. Nobody thinks about what is going on. This guy, and they don't understand the game, these guys. They don't understand it. And they promote you. Nobody knew exactly what we're talking about. My Reverend, I can tell you that today I am also so disgusted, but it's funny to me that the same woman I've been calling her name here, I've not called her name, I always respect because I don't want to call her name on this radio. So what I knew about her, how she came to Biafra Restoration to support what we're doing, how the monies they were raising here, and they're not raising the money she was throwing out, the money she was also raising, that woman has become a saboteur. And somebody that doesn't know her, a rat somewhere he's hiding with a 49 number, is calling on this woman's name loudly on Facebook, insulting and blackmailing this woman. I just watched that video and I said, wow, thank God. The reason I say God, thank God, is because this same woman knew when I asked questions here. This woman was the one they made the liaison officer overnight. This is the same woman they told they're going to buy drones. And the woman came to me and said, oh, you see, I haven't seen your hand in this money being raised for drones. I said, what is the drones for?
And she told me they are planning to buy drones. And I asked her, madam, if you are going to buy drones from, IPOB is going to buy drones to fight, am I not supposed to be the one telling you that we are trying to buy drones? And she told me, but, you know, she left it like that. Truth. That's a critical question that would have helped her to go home and think about what I said to her. But what happened? Similar to Professor Jofo. They threw all their weight on Nnamdi Kanu as a child of God. Continued to mess up Biafrans. Continued to go in their wild ways to destroy our effort for 8 years. And today we are stalled. I would say stalled for the meantime. Stalled for the meantime. It's a big mess. So, Dr. Kaido, we understand we are taking too long, but it wasn't part of what we were doing. We have been moving gradually. You know that. You know that there were hitches along the way. The first arrest, which we all stood and fought until he was released. And once he was released and came, after he ran away from the military, they said that was trying to kill him. He came back here, attended the meeting. The first thing we told him is, you are the one that is always saying, formalize what we are doing. Formalize what we are doing. Everything that was said as far as formalizing what we are doing fell on deaf ears. Thank God we have formalized it today. And people need to understand this, that the setting up of de facto government of Biafra is nothing else. It's not to start another thing, but it's already a moving train that cannot be stopped. It's just, we are calling on you to make yourself available so we can conclude this work. The enemy is standing by. They have break on their plans. Now they have gone into using all these people that call themselves political leaders in our land to be talking about 20. Have not changed the constitution. They have not considered devolution. They have not considered whatever true federalism. I'm just mentioning a few of the things that they always mention when we say we want Biafra. We want out. They have not asked for plebiscite or referendum for people to decide if they want to be part of this contraption. Even as their northern counterpart is calling for referendum, they say they are not willing to continue. Even as their northern counterparts, we are asking the court to put on hold any election, to put on hold that constitutional review that they already stopped until there's a referendum conducted so that people will know where to belong. People will know if they want to continue this arrangement. Our people are no longer into the, every of them is now concerned about few naira's they will grab to offer our people into this evil and barbaric society. That's where we are. That's what is happening today. Because the momentum that has been gathered that would have stopped this nonsense has been polluted. And people don't get it. So we're asking you to please disassociate yourself from these criminal gangs. That all they do is steal your money, collect your money, and blackmail you. That's all they're doing. They collect your money, they put you up there, and then as time goes, once they see, they think you are not putting out money more, they will blackmail you. You become a saboteur. That's what we are seeing today. And then you wondering, for the past 8 years I've been here, refusing everything, sacrificed everything, but not my mother or my father, because my father died 34 years ago. And my mother, I cannot say that I sacrificed my mother. She died of age. But I know when I say sacrifice everything for restoration of Biafra, and somebody is calling me a saboteur. In other words, he wants to get Biafra where nobody will be. As you have witnessed, my reverend, they told you cannot get into Anambra State. And we are here talking about these issues.
They even wrote a memo to that effect. And that is when I know these people don't, they are sick in the head. They never consider,
the real sick.
How will our people feel if they know such thing is done to me?
Can
they
you
a memo to those effect? Chike Doze, no, they are all in my email. I kept all of them. At the right time, the people
and
will see
it. Before, it's a saboteur. And I go for. Now, one man, you know. Now, this right, you want to go for you born on a hanya, you see, on a map, what I found, madam, never, because I don't necessary. If on a wolf, yeah, now we, no, boom, I say, go on, I say. To go, boy. This clown, how am I going to go, I am to get gold. Me, him. God, in the iPhone. Then we are calling on people to disengage from this thing so we can rearrange ourselves. Do what we have to do to get out quickly. And we are having delays from all this nonsense. It is so sad. But in all this, the message must continue. The message must continue. Dear friends, look around you. Mbadike comes here and make an announcement. He gives number on the air. He gives a website on the that you can go and search. So you can come out and support this project. Okonkwo does the same thing. Mazi Onyibe does the same thing. Omami Diopo Onyibe. I can respect that you don't need Mazi. Because sometimes he feels detestful. To bear that name that was generally called you when we are working together with IPOB. Frank Obidike comes here and call on people. Name them. Chidera Odogan is there. And Selemo Udowe is calling on you. Okwia Wonka is calling. Okay? Dr. Wonka and Kwa have just started a program in United States. People need to listen. And make yourself available. There are so many areas to serve. But I can tell you, if you continue to profess Nigeria, if you continue to profess that, that evil, nothing is going to come out of it but evil. So, the earlier we know this, and I believe that the people in diaspora can do this. Yesterday, when my brother Chimezie said so many things about political process, I kind of said, okay, whatever you guys can do, start doing it. Because that's mine. I'm in support of anything that will bring Nigerian contraption down. I'm not hearing about the project no longer. It seems like they're in a poor state now. Poor, as in P-O-R-E. They are not. I'm not seeing the activity no longer. And this is why we've been calling on everybody. It doesn't matter what group you identify yourself. As long as you want your freedom, we are willing to work with you. Just respect people for what they believe in. Because you cannot tell me to throw away Biafra when over 5 million and counting, over 5 million and counting has died for this same name. You can't tell me to abandon it. Okay? We are now witnessing some of these areas that you hear about genocide and everything. It's in the 100,000. It has not gotten to 1 million. Biafra is 5 million and counting. And you asking me to abandon Biafra? It's not going to happen. It's not going to happen. And you know what? I hear people talking about political process. Whatever you can do, do. But I do know that the restoration of Israel did not come with political process. Because we are good in giving examples. The restoration of the state of Israel, they did not go there and start playing politics. They went there and took what belongs to them. Biafra is our land. I don't know what all these lukewarm activities. Sometimes I begin to wonder. So we don't have at least 10,000 men here in the United States that can come out and stand on the truth and bring down this evil called Nigeria. Because we can do it. I cannot do it alone. The collective effort can do this. We don't need any political process. However, we can, what do you call it? Interface with them. We don't need to go and start forming political parties. If you want to do that, it's up to you. But in my own opinion, I don't think that's what we need to do. The issue of Biafra is long overdue. It's just the lukewarm attitude of our people and too much know-it-all, too much wickedness that we are not sincere to ourselves. And that's why whenever I come here, I call upon ourselves to first of all stay the course and tell ourselves the truth. If you want to do this, we can do. If 100 men can stand up here in the United States today, they will begin to see the significance of what we're doing. Because it has to be with truth. It has to be with truth. It does not have nothing to do with your academia or something. It has to do with will. And the honest and the perfect will is will that is founded on truth, the principle of veracity. No matter what happens, that you tell yourself the truth. And more importantly, we must remove the yeast. We must remove it. Ndị na-achọ enyemaka dị eme mpako. Ndị na-need help dị ebudisie. If you are a doctor or philosopher or whatever in all these things, and you don't even know what you can do to save your people. Okay? If you know all these things and you know every atom and chemical and you cannot come out and train few people. Oblonga buka. Oblonga Nigeria. Nkukapo sanko. It doesn't make sense. Because this is too much. And I don't know why people are winning. Until us Abada. Because I want Afghanistan. A lot of you are quick to come out and say, oh, look at what is happening in Afghanistan. Enepwani Jekube Guinea. You have seen what is happening in Afghanistan. But in a minute, in on every in a gum war, in on every in a wham, a wound chichipuang and chichipuata. I don't know if our people understand the dangers that are right in our face. My Reverend, let me yield for other people to make their contribution, but I want to thank you for what you're doing for us. I want to bless your family. Your family, God must find a way to bless you for what you're doing for us. And God will bless. particularly the ones that have Biafra heart. All hail Biafra, and God bless the people of Biafra. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, sir. And of course, your present and that of all the noble Biafrans across the globe remain an inspiration to what we do. And we thank God for his mercy towards all the people of Biafra. And of course, we are reaching closer to the end of this program. I may have to take one call more, and then maybe we call it a day. But the people of Biafra must remain focused. We are not going anywhere. A lot of contribution, a lot of ideas, a lot of suggestion has been made by a few callers to this program today. But I will make every one of us understand that most things we see here may be altered authoritatively, for maybe sick of trying to point out to what we mean. But then, we do not have the final say. And like Dr. Kadu said earlier, most of this discussion will be coming up as interaction session. And so the people of Biafra could have their say in our say. Whatever we say here, we're not trying to tell you this is supposed to be, these are, none of us has been freedom fighter before now. It's not, of course, we now have career freedom fighter, but it's not a career. And certainly, we make so much mistakes, hopefully, we're able to amend our way. And so, to those listeners to Biafra Human Right and Freedom Radio Station, you have the privilege, you have the right to come in and make your own suggestion. But don't do it in form of allegation. And if it is something you are assuming, do not forget that assumption does not have any legal backup in the law court. But let God guide us. I will stop that. And then call on WhatsApp. Can you hear me? Call on WhatsApp.
Good evening, dear Bonyibe.
My brother, good evening from here. You're welcome to the program. Go ahead, please.
Thank you. I thank God for the life he gives his people, for we to be alive in the land of the living ones. Today, many things are going on in Biafra land. But those solutions, who will carry it on? Those who know the truth, supposed to do the truth, and those who know the needful, supposed to do the needful. So what I want to talk in this struggle, some people let me use this exercise, I call it self-promote. If you want that jail program, the jail talks sense, but after talking sense, he behaves ignorant. He knows that what DSS is talking is out of sense, and what Ejimako and Ejiofor is talking is out of sense. But because he is under command and control, and she is pleasing them, she is begging them for them to unite, do something so that what he is thinking. Can be dissenting with them, because the way she is reasoning, you see that DOS are rubbish, while Ejima she know the needful, but she refuses to do that needful. What is she supposed to do? Is it are doing IPOB one family, and that family is Imran Dekalo family, which IPOB one family Imran Dekalo's family. The question now is, Imran Dekalo was arrested without DOS information. And then the Kano Twitter still on tweeting them that Mazim Nandekalu, everything is okay. For good 1 month, DOS no know that Nandekalu was apprehended. And who is using that is his Twitter? Fine boy. Who is fine boy? Powerful. Now the question they're gonna ask I follow people where they're supposed to they ask their self. Who is this our publicity secretary in the whole world that always talk something or give us instruction? Who is this more powerful, our publicity secretary? Because this criminal brother, he don't come on air to tell them something which they refuse. Call him Nandekalu brother that he don't have power over IPOC. That he will, if he come up, people will see it as if family business. So he should go out. Then he go and start using his fake account, the more powerful, the more publicity secretary. And these people are following IPOB for more than how many years? Then don't know that is in Nandekalu brother that is a publicity secretary. Then he's a now his in-law now joined to financial secretary profit profit. Waiting in the fight, make the money they enter for one family account, IPOB, one family, IPOB, one account. I don't know if these people are reasoning or if they reason why don't they do the needful? Because this is what they're supposed to think or ask question. Who is this a more powerful speaking on behalf of IPOB for more than how many years? Who is he? IPOB. Why is Emma Powerful hiding under social media and the commanding IPOB? And these people will not ask questions. Who is this Emma Powerful for how many years? Now, go out from Emma Powerful. I listen to DOS DOS broadcast this afternoon. It was trying to tell IPOB people the reason they call off. Sit at home, that they are not again for formidable people. They are not formidable people again. Because the question now is, they said that they would do sit at home until Maze Jesus Nandekalu will be released. And the Ejimako and the Ejiofor told them that this is it at home you people are doing. We fastly nail the criminal leader Nandekalu to Elia grave. We fastly nail the criminal leader Nandekalu to Elia grave. So they think they can overpower. Now they tag more on Nandekalu head. I say, who hold on Nandekalu is ROC Igbo or Fonogu, nine arrested in Nandekalu. Because this DOS, they must cause another problem. Because this moment now, this useless boy call himself Darlington. He come on air today to nail wait till they call him. Nenayaya Sabotua. telling him that in the is a saboteur. He don't know that that word he is talking, that Nnamdi the Kanu is not happy from him. And this Darlington is the one that we do them many things because he think that he stand by Nnamdi the Kanu. He don't know that what he is doing is against Nnamdi the Kanu because that is one family business, which Darlington did not know. So I want this message to go viral. Let Darlington know that he is a fool. He no get sense. Now, Ejimakor and Ejiofor, they go visit Nnamdi the Kanu every day. Nnamdi the Kanu is very healthy, strong, and everything. But the question, who see him? Now, it is only Nnamdi the Kanu brother, which is why did the DSS did not arrest Emma Powerful? Is the DSS did not know the kind of crime Emma Powerful committed, which he is under suspension, being suspicious to arrest? Then he went to DSS. Then the next thing, Ejiofor come tell them that Nnamdi Kanu have give his brother power to they will be listening to. So what is the meaning of that one family? Is that never clear their eye now that they are not fighting for Biafra? They are fighting for one family. Every IPOB listening, IPOB are not fighting for Biafra. They are fighting for one family. Will it be the family where then they fight for? The master prophet, the master criminal, have master that family will be Nnamdi Oku family. Nnamdi the mother will become Virgin Mary, where they go get pregnant outside out of his father, his husband, which did they call and dead Sammy. Dead Sammy, when you see her. Now, Nnamdi Kanu father will be a Joseph carpenter, a carpenter man. And Nnamdi Kanu will be, then Nnamdi Kanu will become, what did they call him? Jesus, that is the Savior. And there are this fighting for Biafra. How many people die for sit at home? Start killing many people for sit at home. Then other come, according to the DSS, Chinasawuru said that after the meeting with the IPOB in Palestua, IPOB worldwide. I said, who, this guy, did he have sense that after they are in Palestua and they buying Cambodia hacker information, because I listened the day Nnamdi Kanu is saying it, that IPOB will be paying their Cambodia international information hacker with the American district. These people did not ask questions. I will be repeating this word here anytime I want to talk. Any Biafran platform I go to, I will continue to repeat this word. The first question is, this IPOB, they are paying Nnamdi Kanu UN security money. Because Nnamdi Kanu said that the pardon, UN give him a pardon. That is why Zoo will not touch him, and they give him security to secure him. Now the question is, where is UN security? Because the video there, the pictures today, where Nnamdi Kanu stand with the UN securities that is guiding him, that a Zoo cannot touch him. Now, where is the UN security? Abiyomote Biafra. You know, they ask himself this question. He was reasoning all these things, but he will not find out that you are not, she is not fighting for that Biafra. She is fighting for the Kano family. If she is fighting for Biafra, she's supposed to know that this Biafra, when we they pay security, UN security, where we they pay money, and the UN security there, they hold Nnamdi Kanu till today. UN never asks about him. Now, where did he go, and who sent him there? He went. Ask that question. Ordinary zoo, police or zoo military, and then come catch an international man with the UN security. Put them where they chop. Let it be this food when our sa people there. Two chin kafa because. They don't agree give and rice, man. Now, two chinkafa, you go to chop that place, man. In the insult house, people. So, I want all these IPOB fools. They will be on this platform now, typing rubbish. Who be this? Who be this? Common debate. None of IPOB will come for debate or to challenge. For them to get common sense, what their sense they have been, they have been banalized their sense that they cannot reason. Their reason is like a zombie, as a fellow singer, Ajajo Arajoro. That is common sense. Tell them to go straight, Ajajo Arajoro. So that is the IPOB common sense. And what look at what China Saworu that the order from above that they should stop sit at the home. So the order from above, they will not doubt program now to release their leader. They didn't get any program again. Because it might be the last program now. They want to start protests in Zoom. Order from above say no, they go kill people. They put them to sit at the home. No, order from above tell them say no, no sit at the home. It's to take condition. Any condition they tell him Nnamdi Kanu that he will use come out. He will accept it. Then his brother have already make it clear that highest it will end up in round table. He posted it in his platform, Kanu. Unless he don't go remove him because they sabi how to remove something. If not, he posted it that it will end in round table. This is what he posted, which people carry it. They call this bingos. That bingos, all these bingos writing for here, bingos, go to Emmanuel Okalon Takalo and check that it must end up in round table. Then you ask yourself, which round table will be that one? Signed, sealed, delivered. But the issue is that Nnamdi Kanu, nobody will sign, seal, to deliver him a. The one they sign, because the one they sign is sealed, give up. He messed them up. He messed everybody up. He messed Ojo Zokalo up. He messed all the senators, even Ike Ekweremadu that fought very well to release him. He messed Ike Ekweremadu up. Even everybody that helped him, he messed everybody up. So now there is all these people thinking that Nnamdi Kanu on October 21, nobody is bringing in Nnamdi Kanu to court. I probably ready, and now you cancel sit at home because that day any seat at home that day we nail on Nnamdi Kanu again to earlier grave, says by. And now I see something when Ujofo write Ojofo is trying now to run from Nnamdi Kanu case. Let it be clear now. Ojofo is trying to run because Ojofo is warning IPOB that the people are now getting heavy. That they were seeing them as an armed struggle freedom fighter, which him, Ojofo, is not what to represent them in armed struggle. That Ojofo is representing the legal terms of self-determination. Ojofo, right, is in Ojofo's Facebook rant because. So very soon, Ojofo will left them and their eye will clear. And when Ojofo left them, their eyes will clear. Because after October 21, when they no see Nnamdi Kanu and where they did not bring him to court, that is where they will know that Ejimakor and Ojofo never see that criminal since he was arrested. Because Ejimakor, they did not know that Kanu was arrested because his criminal brother, IPOB One Family, was using his Twitter, lying to them. He thought that Nnamdi Kanu, because Nnamdi Kanu gave him Twitter to be lying to Biafrans so that he will go to Kenya. According to the meeting he went to, he will go to Kenya and sign his seal again so that he will know how to lie. They will say, oh, Oyendu is on the line. He was tweeting every day. Without knowing that Nigeria set a trap for him, he went to Kenya to go and collect money. Then he see himself where they panicked him for in a, according to one of Biafran man where they do comedy. He say for the, in a Kumasi, in a Kunkum. He find himself where they beat him in a Kumasi, in a Kunkum. Joba, I'm done today.
Thank you very much.
I want to make you use that your language.
He who do he. The earlier they understand, the better. But of course, we continue progressing. Thank you very much for joining me this evening. And I will say good night from here. And hopefully, this is where we are going to draw the curtain on this evening segment. We continue to do the work of renovation. Tomorrow is the day. Understand what my brother was saying. It is human that makes human to be human. Don't forget that. And of course, we continue from there. Sincere appreciation to those of you who called in and make your own contribution. Apology to those of you who cannot take their call at this moment. We continue from where we stop tomorrow. I encourage you, see how you can contact the de facto customary government members or leaders to see how you can partner with the people to have your sea in their sea. And of course, the African Nation Alliance are available globally to guide you. This is the time to reason, fashion out ways, pattern, modalities. Like Dr. Kado made clear this evening, there is no time. We're wasting too much time. But of course, everything is not to be said here. In the inside, you will hear the true discussion. And we will reveal every agenda. And I tell you, the one that represents or protects the overall interests of the Biafran people will be initiated. If it goes well, then we give God the glory. If it did not go well, then we will stand our ground till it gets well. And of course, at this moment, we want to say good night. And then special appreciation and thanks to every man and woman who has worked very hard to make sure we are still here. Day one, and good night from here.
Abbas, yeah.